Shortly after the release of the Bunyangabo County legislator, Davis Kamukama, from civil imprisonment in Luzira, more two MPs have been sent to prisons as judgment debtors for failure to settle their loans, which attract interest every night and day.
Ugandans would be asking why a member of parliament would borrow money from a moneylender. Sometimes it is our financial indiscipline, but sometimes it is the pressure from our relatives, friends, and the constituencies.
Politicians, generally, they need a background in financial management and how to manage their debts, because everybody must have debts, governments have debts, but how do you manage them?
According to the spokesperson of Luzira Prison, Frank Baine, prisons are now homes to 458 inmates who are committed to prisons over failure to pay their debts. Baine says the number of judgment debtors keeps on growing, which is also contributing to overcrowding in prisons.
Nationally, we are having 420 civil prisoners. And the civil prisoners, in this case, we have the majority have on personal defaulting, especially on payment of loans. And that's why most of them are known as judgment debtors.
However, some legislators believe provisions for civil imprisonment have been abused by money lenders to embarrass their debtors, especially politicians. They believe some lenders are used by opponents of some MPs in constituencies to damage their reputation. They now propose some reforms in the law.
Now this law needs to be revised, because that law was intended for people who have property. But these days, even those people who are borrowing without what? Without property and without money, but they go to borrow. So the law needs to be strengthened, such that now they look at that. Suppose you borrow and you don't have money to pay, or to fear to be embarrassed.
So we really want to encourage civil justice in this matter, and we want to start by encouraging those who owe people, or those who have obligations to pay debts, settle your debts.
Baine explains that most people who are committed to prisons as judgment debtors complete the entire jail term of 6 months without settling their debt obligations, and they're released at the end of the day, save for the few individuals who raise some money and rescue themselves from jail. Then one wonders whether arresting a debtor helps the lender to recover their money.
Yeah, apart from few who have the capacity and have some delays, the majority are genuinely unable to pay. So they spend those 6 months.
You don't pay, they will take you to a civil prison if they fail to trace your property. And don't even be tempted to think when they take you to civil prison, you serve 6 months, that's the end. Once they are able to trace your money, once they are able to trace your salary, they can still follow up and recover.
Civil imprisonment was meant for those who are able but willfully refuse to pay a debt or obey a decree of court requiring such specific performance. Lawmakers have mixed opinions on this. Some claim that people are sent to civil imprisonment when they are willing but unable to pay.
The original intention was for people who have money but they are refusing to pay stubbornly, and they would hide money and not pay stubbornly. So the law was put there that maybe when they go to prison, they would be embarrassed, and the following day they would pay.
By the time you get to the point of going to civil prison, you have exhausted pre-existing remedies.
Meanwhile, to keep a judgment debtor in jail, the moneylender has to pay an upkeep of 3,000 shillings to Uganda Prison Services per day a debtor spends in prison. But the prison spokesman says this money is too little to take care of a prisoner, and they want it revised upwards.
Maybe we shall have to appeal to court at the increase. But remember, these are people who have failed to pay their financial obligations. So now when you also increase the burden on the one who is complaining, they take these people to prison because they have not been paid. Then you increase the burden of making them pay.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.